Welcome to the program, and thank you so much for tuning in today to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Glad that you could join us. We're winding down this month of August 2017, and it's still a few days left in National Breastfeeding Awareness Month. And our guest today is Natasha Trenev. She's a founder and president of Natren, a leading manufacturer of pharmaceutical-grade quality probiotics. She's joining us here today on Health Professional Radio to talk about Bifidobacterium infantis, or B. infantis, the most beneficial bacteria predominant in healthy infants. And she's also going to discuss some of the common issues for kids who are born without this bacteria. Welcome to Health Professional Radio, Natasha.
Thank you so much for having me on board.
Thanks for taking the time and talking with us about Bifidobacterium infantis. First of all, give our listeners a bit of background about yourself as a scientist, and talk about founding of Natren.
Thank you. I've been in the probiotic field for 50 years. Started with a family yogurt business. We introduced a natural Bulgarian-style yogurt and liquid acidophilus in the 1960s. And I'm the one who brought the word probiotics to the health food industry in 1981. And popularized the word in multiple countries across the world, including Australia, New Zealand, England, Belgium, Holland, which is known as Benelux, and in Germany. So I did the pioneering work to introduce the concept of probiotics. And as a consequence, all of the products that I make are research formulated and produced by me under my strict guidelines to make sure that each and every product delivers results to the end user. And it's really a dedication that I've spent my whole life creating to make sure that people get results when they take these miraculous products, because we now know from research that the microbiome and the health of the microbiome affects every health and disease state in the body.
What is the difference between a probiotic and an antibiotic? And why is this probiotic so important, especially during breastfeeding, this being Breastfeeding Awareness Month?
Right. Well, first of all, the word antibiotic literally means against life. And it's when it's necessary, it certainly saves your life. But unfortunately, we've been using antibiotics indiscriminately, and they destroy both the beneficial neutral and bad bacteria found inside our body and everywhere in every organ of our body. As a consequence, you know, the word probiotics means for life, because these beneficial microorganisms are there to promote good health and good life. So they are a very important part of our daily intake to make sure that this microbiome that we have inside our gut is beneficially balanced, and then if we do take an antibiotic, that we can restore that balance by the proper use of a probiotic.
Now, Bifidobacterium infantis, we're here to talk today about this this bacteria. It's said to be the most beneficial bacteria in healthy infants. What is Bifidobacterium infantis, or B. infantis?
Yes, well, first of all, it is what I call the baby bacteria. It is a bacteria that's been around since the existence of mankind on this planet. It is the bacteria that healthy mothers, when they breastfeed their child that was vaginally born, stimulate the growth of this bacteria. And this bacteria, as a consequence, produces healthy growth and development in the infant. And unfortunately for us, in the westernized cultures especially, about 97% of the children born in the North American continent are not able to get this beneficial bacteria from their mothers, even if they're born vaginally or breastfed. And that's a big concern, especially to many research organizations, such as the good folks at the University of California at Davis, who have been studying this bacterium for well over a decade. And I actually introduced this concept almost 30 years ago through my research from, you know, international and European researchers about the benefits of bifidobacteria and healthy newborn infants. So what we have here is, you know, an eco change in the infant that has been brought about possibly by environmental toxins and the abuse of antibiotics, because the Bifidobacteria infantis is very sensitive to antibiotics. And so as a consequence, we recommend that mothers who are contemplating on, you know, giving birth, start taking the B. infantis bacteria in the last trimester of their pregnancy, and also give it to their infant once it's born, even if they're breastfeeding, because believe it or not, breast milk and this bacteria have co-evolved, so that breast milk has specific dietary stimulants only for this bacteria, Bifidobacterium infantis, in healthy infants. So I think the rationale here is, and that I've been talking about for the last 30 years, is that we should try to encourage what is naturally best for the health of our infants by making sure that if we're breastfeeding the child, and even if we're formula feeding the child, that we give this essential bacterium to the child so that they has a chance to implant in the child's GI tract and promote good health.
How recently did researchers notice this this change in infants who are now not getting this bifidobacterium? You're saying that it was occurring naturally long before, since the beginning of time, basically, is what you suggested. So is it
right? Well,
the antibiotics in the water, in the food that we're growing?
Yes, I think that the toxic chemicals, the antibiotics, actually, my attention was called to this problem by a publication in a European journal where it stated that there was noted a decline of Bifidobacteria infantis in westernized countries. And since nobody knew what I was talking about, you know, they didn't know what Bifidobacteria infantis are. They didn't know anything except Lactobacillus acidophilus. The general public was totally uneducated. And so even though I was sounding the alarm, nobody was listening. That this is not a good trend, that we should try to stimulate what's naturally occurring and what is naturally best for the infant's health. And so as a consequence, that's why we're in this position we are today, where virtually 97% of the children, even if they're vaginally born and breastfed, do not have this bacterium present on the North American continent.
So how can we begin to educate our healthcare professionals in order to get this healthy bacteria back to an acceptable level in our healthy infants?
Well, I think fellows at the University of California at Davis, including my efforts, I'm doing programs such as yours. I think now my advice is much more acceptable because prominent universities in North America are starting to talk about this. And I think that each health professional should investigate for themselves. And as a company that has been producing this bacteria for at least 25 years and making it available in three various carriers, one is in a organic brown rice formula, the other is in a goat's milk formula, and one is in a cow's milk formula. Whatever formula suits the interests of your infant best, it's important to get this bacteria introduced to the mother and the infant on a regular basis to make sure we return to what we call an optimal state in our infant's health.
Now, where can we go online and get more information about Natren and this baby bacteria, as you call it? How long has Natren been in existence, and where is the company located?
We have been around for 35 years. We have an incredible safety record. There has been no complaints filed against us ever. There are no complaints ever filed against us, even with the Better Business Bureau. So we have an impeccable reputation, and we are located in Westlake Village, California, which is in the suburb of Ventura County. And we've been operating out of the Westlake Village pharmaceutical grade production facility since 1990, but we have been in business for the last 35 years. You can go to www.trynatren.com or just www.natren.com and go under the term Life Start, which is the name of the product that contains the Bifidobacterium infantis exclusively. So, you know, don't be fooled by people who claim they have B. infantis and then mix it up with a lot of other bacteria. That's not going to help your infant or increase the chances of them reaching their optimal healthy state.
appreciative of you coming in and sharing this information with us. I'm hoping you'll come back and speak with us some more.
It'd be my pleasure. And anytime you wish to have me, just let me know, and I'll be glad to come back and tell you about some of the other wonderful things we're finding about probiotics and the health of the microbiome.
Natasha Trenev, thank you so much. You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. Natasha is the founder and president of Natren. Transcripts and audio of this program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au and also at hpr.fm. You can subscribe to this podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud. And be sure and visit our affiliates page when you visit us at hpr.fm and healthprofessionalradio.com.au.